So very cool map here, some cool opportunities to get some open space combat as well as, you know, some really close quarters stuff. I'm thinking, you know, these teams have been running very traditional comps, so we haven't seen too much difference in what they look like, but it's never too late to surprise us. But already looking at the picks, it looks like we're kind of seeing the traditional meta picks that we've seen before.
The traditional Chicago comp.
Yes, this is the Chicago comp.
All right, let's update that score on there.
So yeah, that's Onyx. Geez. Onyx is up 1-0 right now. We're gonna have a quick pause here so we figure out what's going on.
All right. So again, for those of you that are keeping track, we can't say the play is definitely different here for these two teams. A lot more calculated approach. The more unconventional team comps, I think to answer that, I would say probably dive comp is categorized as something, but not a non-conventional. I would say a non-conventional would be as if you're seeing a particular role that's not filled. Sometimes you'll maybe see a solo heel, I would say, is maybe an unconventional.
Well, a lot of teams are still not comfortable running Orisas or using Sombras, things like that. Things that aren't designed to just stop and kill the other team, but rather run disruptions and coordinated plays. So to make things like a Sombra work, or really to make a Torbjorn work, you do need a team that's ready to support that play style and adjust to it. It's not the same thing as just the wall against the other wall. A lot of it's zoning and making
sure
that's...
Well, it's more calculated approach. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's what you see with a team that takes the time to, you know, play together.
Yeah, so I mean, real simple example, you put a turret here, now you've got this area zoned. I mean, there's other responses to that, but that's kind of the general idea, which is different style. And Trades goes down real quick, really aggressive positioning there. And already Onyx is out too, which is not looking good. As
well, we got to run. I was going to say, we got some switches on the rolls here on Team Onyx as well.
Yeah, this is going to be a hard point for them to hold right now.
So we got Trades taking off of the, not doing the Reinhardt this round. We got Kaiwa Senpai pulling that up. Yep. Zave again doing the fair DPS. Ana again by Shy Guy. Irritable doing the healing. And Carrie on the DPS.
Carry opting for this DPS. This hit scan is so good. Look at that. Right on shot.
Look at that. Looked like he was running his alt there. Wow.
Ooh, Zave gets getting popped by Shock and Awe. Quite sent by moving up. Usually a really common D.Va player. Strange to see her on Ryan. And Team Onyx just folds up right away.
I'm actually kind of interested that Ruby, that Shock and Awe hasn't opted for the soldier to take down Zav. But I guess Dekurin, I pronounced that correctly, is got that covered though with his aim.
Yeah. Ooh, Zave comes in, picks up that.
As I say that, it happens.
Yeah. Really good play there. Manages to pick up, save his Roadhog buddy. Tries to pop Yugs off
that. So when you see that concussive shot behind Ryan, the idea is that you push Ryan out of position despite him having the shield up.
Carry pops that ult, tries to see, and Eve gets Ana ult.
Oh, he's trying to
be able to do a lot,
around.
But look at that. Gets ulted, but it doesn't matter because their whole...
Tremulous snuck in there.
Yeah, really smart play there. He was hiding back, and Casey knew it, but just wasn't able to get back there in time.
Yeah.
But
so let's see.
Carrie is able to maybe stabilize. This is interesting. But Ruby is still moving this forward. It's just they're very in a weak position. But Ruby is moving the payload up. Irritable's trying to move around, but that's dangerous stuff to be the only one up there.
Mm-hmm. Still moving it, still pushing the payload. Right up here to that checkpoint. They got plenty of time.
Ooh, Kwai Senpai pops the ult, and I don't think anything went down there. Yu's kind of moving Trades.
Yeah.
Getting on there at the last second with his ult. We got 0.82 to go.
Oh, Trades says no. Let's push him off. Let's get some time.
They might get more than time here. Onyx is able to hold the whole point here for a full hold.
So they're going to push that back. So wow.
This is a good position for them. That's a pretty good spawn.
Do you know what is the timer set on the payload till it goes reverse? Do we know what that is to be off the point? To look that up.
I mean, not long. I mean, it's going to start moving backwards, as you can see right there. Mug's got a good alt opportunity there, but
not quite far enough
catch
reach.
Anybody is able to nail Shy Guy, and this time the payload is for sure making it through.
Yeah, but that's great though. Look at how much time it bought him.
Great for Team Onyx.
Yeah.
So here we go on the last portion of this move here.
Ruby's getting position. Shouts, oh, look at that, going right around the back.
That's
going
dangerous.
For the hook. Oh!
Save.
And that's what happens. That's what happens.
I don't know. That's a lot to just burn on one hero.
Hey, they poked the bear, they got burned. That's what happened there.
More like nuked, it really is.
Yeah.
More of what we saw there. But Dakiran is able to pick up Irritable, which makes this kind of an even fight.
I'm interested in that Onyx didn't try and hold further up. Was it that they didn't get there in time, or is this deliberate here?
Probably deliberate. You can kind of get to that high ground easily, and it can be challenging
that
to hold
semi
up.
On the left side there.
You definitely don't want to be losing this amount of ground if you can help it.
Yeah, this is really, I mean, they're really mowing it over here.
So they're just hoping, I think, to hold them kind of at the last possible second here.
Yeah. So we're coming in the 3 minutes left mark. Again, more than enough time. I think Ruby can kind of, take their time and strategize how they want to push this in here.
Yeah, the
where's
Dakuran?
We got an alt here from him as well.
Ooh,
wow.
Shouts. Nice pickup there.
Again, carry with that hit scan. Wow. Mm.
But he pops his hit scan directly into... That Ryan isn't going to... Well, I guess it ends up working.
Well,
as
Yuke's
is way
worked.
Up, and his team is way back. So Onyx with another opportunity here to hold this payload before it goes in. We'll see if they're able to do it.
That's a pretty good hold there. I was very surprised.
We got some good alts, too, out of Team Onyx here, which is great.
Shoutso is a sub-in for this week, but playing very sneaky. Mm-hmm. Very sneaky, going around the side there. Look
around.
At that. Oh!
I thought Carry was landing on the payload.
Yes.
Zave, look at that sneaky little ground alt there. Totally negates Yug's alt, and that means that Team Onyx is going to hold again.
Wow. It's two holds.
But Shouts being that
and
sneaky hog.
We're rounding the two-minute mark now, so... Ruby's got to figure out what they're going to do here.
Zave have wall hacks on. Doesn't matter. Shot's able to pick him up, but the whole team
like,
just
get
collapses
out.
On him.
Oh, we got an alt here coming out of care with Senpai. And Dakuran is still holding on to that Deadeye.
Yeah, he's getting in position up there. You can see him getting ready. But you can see Shrade's getting also preparing to kind of get up there. Whole team's kind of trying to figure out what they're going to get. Ooh, Carry pops the cure with the help of Xave. Xave just to keep him down. Why sent by Alt Tremulous. Really starting to just swing her hammer mad there. Ops to Alt.
Wow.
And get the
and
res
And the
up.
Res as well. Zave not taking advantage of that powering up as much as I thought he would.
It is challenging. I mean, you only get so many shots.
Yeah.
But he does have his ult up, and Carry's got his ult. So it's two strong DPS ults. But Tremulous is really going to be the player to watch here, I think, as his ult is really going to be what's going to shift this play. So keep an eye on that Red Mercy if you can. Both teams looking. This is pretty much Team Ruby's last push right here. We got a lot of people coming up. Zave picks up one. This is now 5v6. Kwai Senpai, though. Shield goes down. Now they're just starting to collapse on him. Not good. Zave, though, pops his ult. Picks up a couple. But here comes the rest.
Tremulous
keeps people up as he's running, but their whole team is just collapsing. Tremulous is not going to be able to push this on his own. And Shouts tries to move up there. Takes a taunting Shrades, but... gets popped, and that's it for Team Ruby right here. So they're looking at pretty good push.
Yeah, that was very good. Yeah, nice run. I was really mistaken. I didn't think Onyx was going to hold when they positioned themselves in the back like that. That just didn't look... To me, I didn't think they were going to hold it. They were really pushing it close.
Absolutely. And I think the advantage with a spawn, you know, as it gets further back, your spawn improves because you have less time to get to the payload. Mm-hmm. Downside being you have less opportunities. But again, if you wipe at any point along that strip, there's no way you're going to recover. So
yeah. If you play a tight, you know, like we were saying earlier, a tight, very deliberate team strategy, that also will play to your benefit because you know when your spawn times are, you're starting together, and just much, you know, just I'm very distracted by what's going on here. There's some action at Ignite. But if they're playing very deliberate, that can also work to their advantage at that point, holding it in the back. If you're a disorganized team, you don't have a lot of space to be disorganized, is my point.
Yes, I agree with that. And I mean, a lot of it does come down to teamwork. You know, what are the teams doing to practice this stuff together? Are they trying different things? I mean, when your back is against the wall like that, there's strategies you can bust out. You don't need to keep doing the same thing. You could put in a May. You could put in a Junkrat. Are those things that are going to work in that moment? Mm-hmm. We were talking earlier about unconventional comps. I mean, when you're getting pushed down like that, doing some quick switches to some holding heroes, Tracer, May, D.Va, these sort of heroes last a really long time on the point. And if you're, you know, looking down the barrel of a loss, you might be able to push out that timer potentially and take it to overtime.
Mm-hmm. And not to mention that curveball to the opposite team.
Absolutely. They're used to shooting one specific type of person, and now you got somebody else. It's going to be tricky.
Yeah.
But, again, very traditional comps out of both these teams. Shouts is really the only switch that we're seeing that's notable over to Azaria. Might be able to deal with Zave's splash damage, but other than that, we'll see if she's able to get charged. But that kind of forces Team Onyx to have some good shot control, or else they're going to find themselves charging Shouts and looking at 100 energy Zarya.
So they're all camped up again on top of Big Earl. So we saw this last game as well. See if they stay up there.
Another great
play. So that was that concussive shot that we saw bumped off that Rhine off the top of the building there. Just broke the team apart. Now they're trying to come back together again.
And look at that space that he creates with that boop. Yes. It completely opens them up.
Not all the heroes can just jump off that ledge and immediately answer. They're going to have to reposition themselves, otherwise they're all done for.
And Chris creates so much chaos as well. So Shock and Awe doesn't get the pharmacy as much as Zave does, but Zave's already got his... was already getting charged up. He's just kind of dropping back a little bit as they exchange some blows. So this is where... you know, shot control is really important. You don't want to shoot that shielded.
Well, we got Shreds targets. Coming up here on an alt much faster than Yugs is. So we got Onyx again. Looks like they're playing a little more aggressive.
Ooh. Ruby, though, picking up some great kills here.
Absolutely. They bounced back. That was...
That's it for Shy.
We'd say maybe to Curran, it might have been to his credit. I feel like he single-handedly really pushed back there.
Yeah, got a lot of clutch shots there. You know, when it comes to McCree, get a couple headshots and you're totally, you know, wiping targets quick. Do some sneaky maneuvers there. These Pharah plays are so deadly. You know, you got some
very, very well. there we go, Pharah on Pharah.
Carry gets taken out.
Ooh. And also that concussive shot is used to evade. Wow, nice takeout there.
You got a nice...
Uh-oh. Yeah, throw that shield up.
Oh, wow. Good cover there. That's some really good teamwork. Oh, he picks up Shock and Awe, drops his shield, and he's getting healed up by Mercy. So this looks like Team Onyx is going to be able to push through on this point here. Maybe get a really nice scatter, potentially. They'll be resin at different levels here, so that means that you're going to have a lot more time to cure in with his ult, but Zave popped him. Didn't even see it coming.
Wow.
So we saw Shock and Awe save this point last time on Eichenwald with an unbelievably cool ult. We might be able to see it again here. There he... Oh my god, I flipped for the wrong one.
Oh, way to bring the hype up.
I know, the hype went up and then it went down. But they managed to take the point. Thank God. I was so worried. I saw Azaria ult and I panicked.
All right, so Onyx is coming here. They're rounding it with just over 3 minutes of time left. They got plenty of time. Well, not gobs of time, but plenty.
Yes.
You know, Team Ruby was predicted to be a pretty strong team, which they are, and
they're still strong, but we were having people saying that it was going to be the next Team Fire, which was Season 1 champs.
Bold statement.
I know. All right, we got shouts in there.
Shouts from Dave. You know, he's nearly uncontested.
Look at that. Wow. No one is going after her down there.
These teams, though, I mean, they're not necessarily utilizing the Rhine Shield, but they're making it work.
Well, I don't know, maybe you could speak better to this, but I have to say the Rhine advantage I've been noticing is they've been leveraging the alt more than the shield sometimes.
Yeah.
I mean, that's...
you can see Yuge just over there just swinging like mad. He's not really too worried about shielding unless it's kind of for himself. Ooh, that no look.
Wow.
Diva pilot kill right there.
That was pretty aggressive.
And it looks like we're going to have Team Ruby stabilize a little bit here on the point.
Kind of position themselves, yeah.
The thing that's been cool about these teams is that, you know, with these Pharahs so deadly and pocketed, they can really, even when their teams are behind and regrouping, they can apply pressure kind of throughout. So you see Zave, you know, the rest of the team's building up, but he's still applying a lot of pressure to them. And if he's able to pop a quick kill, totally turns the game around.
It's neat to be able to see from that third person and kind of see how the team is spread out. There's an ult there.
Picks up the Ana. Not enough, though.
No. Shock and Awe was trying to get there. It didn't look like he got there in enough time.
The Tremulous just doing his thing.
Ruby looks a little spread out right now. A little spread out.
There's a lot of individual combat that's just occurring kind of across the map right
now.
Well,
Yves, going back to that, now that I'm starting to notice when he's pulling his shield up, I mean, he's by Tremulous now, so he's helping the healer.
Not able to finish him.
Carry close and ready to ult up.
So we're going to have that nice little combo here, potentially. There it is. Is he going to get the Ana? He is.
Nice work.
But Yuge is just defending him, which is very strong.
Yeah,
Zave
good job.
Is ulting somewhere. Dakuren manages to pick off one as Team Onyx is trying to move up here.
Then
they
Shy
gotta pick up Tremulous,
you.
And they do, which is awesome for them. Great D-heal.
Wow. Almost missed the sleep. No.
But we've got Shock and Awe alting up on that point, but Zave takes him out. Really nice moves out of Onyx here, and they're going to keep moving this card forwards.
Nice work, Onyx.
You can hear Team Onyx getting fired up behind us, which is, you know, what we saw with the team last time, you know, just the games right before this.
See these that teams, momentum.
Yes, that momentum's huge.
Yeah. So Onyx is taking it nice and slow in here, with Shreds leading the charge. All right, this is where Rhine is going to make or break because of this. Again, we were talking about the small corridors. This is that's going to be a huge, huge turning point is if you can get those shields down and just open it up.
And Shreds does have his ult up. They're just waiting for his shield to break, and then I guarantee you're going to see.
Yep.
Big ult.
So let's see. Almost.
Slice up. I picks up one, but Dakuren ults
his
ult down.
Cleans house.
So the shielder ran away from him and left him high and dry
Man.
And Team Ruby is going to secure the point with a minute left.
Ruby's going to be okay. That was some good teamwork. Way to just take that pendulum and swing it the opposite direction. I love that coordinated alt there between D.Va and Rhine, though. That was pretty cool. Bring down the shield with the D.Va, strike the hammer down.
Yeah, very clever moves there, but unfortunately with Dakuren up there, he totally had their number and just sniped them all down.
Yeah.
We got two D-heals on...
those D-heals are really powerful.
Go. Team Ruby starting to collapse here, and we got Zave ready to do it.
Coming in, we see another. Was that another Deadeye over there?
But it's not gonna. This time, it's not gonna work.
No.
And they got the point. Onyx starting to push in here. Maybe they... Oh, yeah.
Oh, boy.
Yug's just a little out of range. Ruby's trying to hold on as tightly as they can, but I don't think they have a shot.
I don't know. Shakanaw was the last one to go down there at the end. Wow. All right.
So Onyx picks up two games. Ooh, that res.
Wow.
If only he was there just a little bit sooner, that could have possibly gone a very different direction.
Wow, so we're almost seeing a similar result this round with the two wins right out of the gate.
Ooh, yeah, this is going to be that Deadeye move, which is going to be very cool to see. So let's that pop off. Look at that. Boom.
Bam, bam, bam.
Yeah. Probably could have picked up that other one. Nice plays there.
That's quite the answer. Got him right on the run.
Very cool play out of Onyx here.
Nice. Look at that 60% kill participation by Carrie.
Oh, yeah. Oh, Shy Guy with the six.